Good evening, and welcome to Silent Movie Under the Stars. It's our 10th anniversary. I'm Diana Reisman, Executive Director of Wharton Studio Museum, and I'm so glad to be here in the beautiful and historic State Theatre in downtown Ithaca, New York, for the first live stream version of this annual end of summer event. In the interest of everyone's health and safety during the pandemic, we decided to forego our usual lovely spot at Taughannock Falls State Park and bring you the event virtually. Tonight, we are so excited to be featuring the 1925 silent film, The Freshman, starring the inimitable Harold Lloyd. In 1990, The Freshman was selected by the Library of Congress for preservation in the United States National Film Registry, one of the first 50 films to receive this honor. Wharton Studio Museum works to preserve and celebrate Ithaca's and the region's movie history through exhibits, screenings such as this one, and other programming. In partnership with the Friends of Stewart Park and the City of Ithaca, Wharton Studio Museum is developing the historic Wharton Studio building in Stewart Park into the Wharton Studio Museum and Park Center. Our presenting sponsor for Silent Movie Under the Stars is M&T Bank, and we're so grateful to the State Theater for producing tonight's live stream with live music by Cloud Chamber. I'm thrilled to have with me a special guest. Suzanne Lloyd is the granddaughter of the star of tonight's film, Harold Lloyd. Miss Lloyd grew up in her grandfather's home, known as Green Acres, in Beverly Hills, California. When Mr. Lloyd passed away in 1971, he made his granddaughter the trustee of his film library and his 3D photo library that holds more than 200,000 3D images he took. Miss Lloyd has devoted herself to silent film preservation ever since, and to keeping her grandfather's films and legacy alive by sharing his work with the world. Suzanne, it's a pleasure to have you with us to introduce The Freshman. Your grandfather, alongside Charlie Chaplin and Buster Keaton, is considered one of the most important and influential film comedians of the silent era. Tell us a little bit about him and The Freshman.
Well, Diane, it's a pleasure to be here today and present The Freshman for you and the Wharton Studio Museum. And I want to thank you very much for the wonderful work you do in film preservation and taking care of the silence. I started very young taking care of Harold's films. As you said, I lived with him till he passed in 71. And I started working on actually the core films of repointing nitrate film and adding paper between the emulsions and labeling the cans. And if there was goo in there, cutting it out. So it was a basic training course in film. But I also accompanied him when he used to speak at universities and released two film composites in the 60s and showed it to younger audiences. And he had a great joy about showing his films and reintroducing his film character, the boy or the glasses character, to new audiences. And he was always thrilled with the response because he's your all-American boy, typical boy, guy on the street who could be your neighbor, your cousin, your brother, your best friend, and his familiarity with an audience and a feeling of warmth and a form of a friendship and also of great wit and fast reactions to a situation that he just wanted to be a regular fellow and a regular guy. And the movie you're going to show tonight truly impacts his feelings on how he felt. And this is a film about going to college and your first experience at college, which there are a lot of, you know, children going to college this fall. But in the situation right here with the pandemic, it's sad that they don't have a full experience of it. But it will come back. It will come back. And this film really shows student life, fraternity life, and what happens on football field. It's so interesting that Harold shot the freshman at Berkeley, and he shot at USC, University of Southern California. His football sequences were shot at Berkeley and at USC. He shot with the USC football team, not extras or stunt guys. He said he wanted to use real college players because they knew how to fall, they knew how to move, and they knew how to move a ball. And he said, I can play with them. If I brought in, you know, people to play football players, they couldn't do it. And he came up with an invention, which they use all the time in films now, which was a rolling track. And he put the camera on it so the camera could move with him when he crosses the field and runs for the ball. But years later, Harold was always very involved with SC, and he received a wonderful award for from DKY, which was their actual drama society, film society fraternity. And when he passed away, he offered scholarships to different universities. And SC is where I built a soundstage in his honor. And it was their first soundstage for the students to produce film on. And it was literally built on the land that in the film, The Freshman, you'll see him on a practice field with all the practicing with the football players training to go into the big game. And that's where the soundstage was built, which I always thought that was so sweet, because Harold never went to college, and making this film, I believe, and I think he was very proud of the fact, it was kind of his college experience of how he'd feel as a student and maybe what he'd experience at college. So the freshman was very close to him and very dear to him. And especially in shooting it really on a location of universities.
Well, thank you so much. I mean, that was very interesting about USC. And of course, Ithaca is a big college town, and we have students coming back under to both Ithaca College and Cornell under, you know, very complicated circumstances. So I'm very glad that we're showing The Freshman this year. It seems apt. And I just thank you for sharing that information, those stories with us. And I hope everyone enjoys The Freshman this evening. Let's roll the film.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.